We want to show you something you can have this year. A grand adventure, not in some far corner of the planet, but within convenient reach of your home. A week or two of escape from the stresses of civilization. A chance to experience the pure wonder of the wild America that was. A richly varied vacation that makes relatively modest demands on your time and purse, and practically no demand whatsoever on your energies, for you will be only as active as you please. From lazing in the sun to piloting a canoe through roaring cataracts, or even swimming them if you wish. This is a voyage of renewal, an away from it all outing for the solitary observer of nature, the starry-eyed couple on a honeymoon, or ahead of it, or many years after. It's for everyone in the family from 8 to 80 or older. Born along on one of the great wild rivers, the salmon or the snake of the inland Northwest, you learn how fulfilling, how secure, how downright comfortable wilderness travel can be.
The water, everybody else just passes the boat down hand over hand along this gunnel. That way only the front people get their feet wet. Okay? So on three, we're just gonna move it out nice and easy. One, two, three. Something like cold. Okay, just pass it down.
This is great.
They got a
chance.
They got
a chance.
They've done this before.
Oh, they've done it before.
The main Salmon River begins in the Stanley Basin in Idaho, between the Sawtooth Range and the White Cloud Mountains, both of which fortunately are saved as wildernesses, although the Stanley Basin itself is developed with farming, cattle raising, and nowadays a certain amount of resortism. It's still a pleasant place, and the river begins in that area from all the many streams that flow down out of the Sawtooth Mountains. A beautiful, clear, pure river for the most part, because it doesn't run through any cities, it has no dams on it, it's a natural flow all the time, unaffected by works of man. One of the trips we offer on the wild rivers of the West is for 1 week on the Salmon, through the vast region known as the River of No Return Wilderness. We assemble in Lewiston for the drive across Idaho. Lewis and Clark hoped to reach the Pacific by navigating the Salmon River nearly 200 years ago, but had to give up the idea and proceed on foot over the mountains instead. Well, you know you're really back in the good old days when your gasoline is dispensed by gravity from a hand-pumped glass tank. You can see exactly how much you're getting, though. On we go through wilder and wilder country to the launching ramp at the end of the road at Corn Creek. With boats in the water and everything stowed, we get our safety instructions from Bill Bruchak, our trip leader.
Okay, this life jacket is gonna be the best friend on this trip. I want everybody to adjust them so they're snug. If you're not sure how snug is, when you have a tight, turn to your buddy, grab him by the collar, and try to lift up. If that life jacket comes up over your head, it's not tight enough. Okay, you want to have them so they stay on, they stay in place, and they keep you afloat.
One of the early things that used to happen here was that they built large wooden scows in the upper part of the Salmon River up in the Stanley Basin, and they used to use them to transport cattle down the river, believe it or not. They were big enough that at high water they could make it. And when they got way down in the lower reaches of the Salmon or clear into the Snake River and down to places such as Lewiston, the barges were dismantled, or these scows were dismantled, and the scows were gone when they got to their destination. So the River of No Return became one of those romantic terms.
I just like the right.
Oh, the right looks like you should be able to do it. Oh, yeah. The hole on the right's not that bad.
Oh, no, you can even go over that hole on the right. It's still covered with water.
Yeah, so but you want to hit that slot right between them.
Yeah, you can see that green tongue?
Yeah.
That's where I plan on going. You can even come real close to that hole down that first hole and that second hole.
Right.
I just put my bow right into that.
Right. Right.
Hey, but I'm telling you, if you're not sure about it in any way, don't do it.
At the major rapids, which are never quite the same twice, we often stop so the boatmen can plan their way through.
Hang on, James. Touch it. Hang on. Big stuff. Hang on.
And then Brian, this wall of water, and then this guy in front of me, these arms, just going wild.
That was high and dry.
We name our boats for environmental tragedies, things that man shouldn't have done to the earth and did, and the places he has destroyed. The Salmon River happens to be the one river on which we haven't named, or for which we have not named any of our boats, because it really doesn't have its ecological integrity destroyed. There are things about it, things that have been done to it that we don't like, but they really have not hurt or damaged the river.
The boats are the big thing. We've taken rubber raft trips down the river before, and they're fun, and I enjoy them a lot, but the dories are different. It's more than just that they're pretty boats. It's a different ride, and it's a different feel. It really is.
We've done the raft thing, but the dories, there's an aesthetic thing about them. First of all, they are beautiful boats. Wanted to see how one acted. I mean, you know, wooden boats on a river, not knowing that that's the way it all started. It's been fantastic, a magnificent experience.
Neget Island in Mono Lake, the California coast, the lovely Vale of Ronda in the coal fields of Wales, the Peace River in Canada, we remember these and other places as they once were. On each of our river trips, all the meals are planned in advance.
Yeah.
It's like a mushroom soup tonight for dinner. Making a coleslaw salad over there, apple coleslaw salad.
Oh yeah, yeah, it's my brother's favorite.
Heard about lobster. Oh yeah, there it is!
It doesn't take very much of this to help you decide that you very seldom need to put up your tent.
Finally got two tent stakes in, I'm not taking them back out.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday with you! Happy birthday to you!
We're gonna do a layover day today. So what that means is basically everybody can do whatever they want to do today. We're not gonna go on the river. We're gonna stay here at Groundhog Bar, basically use this as a base. There's gonna be hiking for everybody who care to join us. Volleyball, horseshoes, relaxing time, sitting around reading, whatever you like to do. There's a nice hike back upstream, about a mile and a half, a nice easy hike to an old trading post called Jim Moore's. And I recommend that even those of you that aren't hikers should go on that one, because it's a nice easy hike and it's a real neat place up there. Big meadow, nine cabins. You get to cross the Campbell Ferry Pack Bridge while we're up there. There's going to be another hike for anybody who's interested to a place called Rabbit Point, which is 5.5 miles that way, about 3,000 vertical ascent. A pretty good hike. If you're not a hiker, you probably don't want to go on that one.
Yes, there are the hikes, wildlife encounters, fishing. So many ways to enjoy and draw inspiration from this extraordinary wilderness. So many things you can do on your own. But it's the river that counts most, not just for its splashy exuberance, its ever-changing surface patterns in the calm stretches, or its ever-present repertoire of sounds, but because it is our way through the wilderness, our trail, our motive power. Every day we look forward to where it will take us, the things it will show us, things reserved for the eyes and ears of river voyagers.
Occasionally, if you're lucky, you see an osprey. Don't see them very often. And if you're real lucky and you see an osprey, you see them diving for fish. Mostly trout, later on in the fall, steelhead. You also have quite a large herd of bighorn sheep, a variety of black bear, elk, an occasional moose, bank beaver, otter, some mink, and of course, various species of bullhead.
And how could such an outing end without getting everybody into the final group portrait? Hope those self-timers are working. But the mighty Salmon is just part of a vast river system. It ends where it joins the larger Snake River, the primary tributary of the Columbia, the Great River of the West. The Snake begins in Wyoming in Yellowstone National Park and eventually flows west across Idaho to the eastern edge of Oregon, turning north to form the interstate boundary. Its tremendous canyon separating the wild Wallowa Mountains of Oregon from the craggy Seven Devils of Idaho is called the Grand Canyon of the Snake, or Hell's Canyon. The river itself, about three times as big as the Colorado in total volume, is a delightful wilderness trail, just right for a six-day outing amid these majestic surroundings. Most of the way, the water is flat, the drifting restful as can be. But among all the things to look forward to as we drift along, white water always ranks high. Once the best route through a rapid is determined, we can see how precisely the plan is carried out. And here's what that camera in the second dory saw. Precision. Thank you. Now, what about those inflatable kayaks, affectionately or maybe demeaningly referred to as rubber duckies? Well, of course, they're there for you to use when you want to, and they're remarkably stable as well as maneuverable. If you're not quite sure of your paddling ability, a short lesson by head man Kurt Chang will give you the hang of it.
Time to get over to shore to jump in or not. If you want to just empty the boat of water, just tip it over.
Then you can sally forth and get as wet as you please. Or even maybe just a little bit wetter. Well, you did choose to get close to the river, so this must be your cup of tea. Actually, playing in the water this way can be a big part of the fun. The current promptly carries you into calmer waters, where the dories and your shipmates are standing by, and you can reboard for the next rapid, or board a dory and dry off. After all, that buoyant life jacket floats you high, if not quite dry, in water that's just right for swimming. If you do want to keep splashing to a minimum, you just stay in the dories. Even that may not always work, because you know that on a hot day, there's a tried and true way to cool off a good old-fashioned water fight. Other ways to stay cool include the wave-in-the-face method, and the obvious
9, 8, 7, 6, I forget the rest, jump!
Use your breath, Jillian. Yeah, was it fun? You can do it again?
Yeah.
Yeah? Are you gonna do it again, Jillian?
Yes!
Yes, that was fun. What a swimmer.
Ready, set, go!
And how do you get all those nice wet-looking pictures? Just take your camera with you when you jump overboard. Wildlife is here, it's visible. Yesterday, you know, you saw a large herd of elk, perhaps 40 or 50 of them, and the fishing is wonderful. The kinds of fish are rather spectacular, including the large sturgeon. On one of the guided hikes, you trade some solitude to see things you might never find on your own. A pioneer cabin, a mysterious gold mine, ancient Indian petroglyphs or rock paintings. These rivers are always navigable, but the level of the water does fluctuate with the seasons. Conditions very late in the drought year of 1988, when this presentation was made, called for some fine tuning of our techniques at such tricky places as Wild Sheep Rapid. Great boulders have all but blocked the river. Under that big lump of plastic, of course, is a person with a camera bringing us such scenes as this.
There's a stretch of kind of a flat.
Yeah.
But just as if to remind us that we're not going to hit it just right every time, once in a while the river does take over, though only briefly to be sure, bruising only our egos. So, one golden day follows another, until you almost forget the world of turmoil and tension far beyond the canyon walls. Yes, you can share the joy of these wonderful places, wonderful not only for beauty and solitude, but also for the sheer exhilaration they inspire.
That was great. Big fun.
We're always on hand to answer your questions, and let us send you our illustrated brochure. We do look forward to guiding you down one of the great wilderness rivers of the Northwest.
Hello. like it.
Like it?
White water, rapid.
I never dreamed.
I don't blame you for being scared, miss. Not one little bit. Ain't no person in their right mind ain't scared of white water.
I never dreamed that any mere physical experience could be so stimulating.